I was hoping that Mr. Hemling would be here, and maybe he'll show up in a bit. But my name is Chris Luzon. I'm the secretary here, if anybody doesn't know me. And I'm a grad from 1982. Sure do know how to make an entrance. To get us started, I wanted to bring you way back to Y2K, the year 2000, when some of you were using KY2. Right there? Also, when Wendy's grads first made their mark on the world. Remember when we all thought every computer on the planet was going to self-destruct? And remember when Mr. Mitchell finished his very first year in Barriere Secondary? Both ominous indications that big things were to come. And the year 2000 did not disappoint. In January, Y2K brought us Shakua, Maddie, and Caitlin. In February, Brady. April came with Jerry Lee. May brought us Tyler, Dawson, Shawnee, Sheldon, and John. And June was a big month with Tyra, Wyatt, Chant, and Daryl. In July came Owen, followed by Jake in August. October brought Aaron. And in November, Will, Noble, Damon, and finally in December, we got our babies, Will D and Isaiah. So, with no further ado, starting our show, we have Brittany Spears.
Oh!
and only five girls.
I was in that class.
Smallest grad class since the early 1970s. Anyway, we're going to go on with our show. 2001 was not a year to be forgotten, both good and bad. Not only were we introduced to the Apple iPod, but also witnessed the tragedy of 9/11. I'm sure you can all remember where you were when the Twin Towers fell. I think you can agree with me when I say everyone was feeling a little fearful at that time. So Pixar certainly demonstrated how prevalent fear is for all of us with the creation of Monsters, Inc.
That was upset. I think I'm ready.
You weren't scared to leave home?
Maybe a little. Remember all the things we were scared of when we were younger?
Yeah, I remember being afraid of all the monsters in my bedroom.
I think I'm a little more to be scared of the monsters in my bedroom. Maybe like living costs or tuition?
I don't know. Monsters in your bedroom are pretty scary.
I don't know. What about all the adults in our life, like Miss Dola with her obsession with essays?
Write another draft.
Or Thomas Sini. Family talk, everyone. Nice face, bro.
Wow. Wow, Sully. Wow, Sully, it looks like you're right. There really are scary things with monsters in your closet.
Well, you really are scary. High school. Well, we're going to go on with 2002, and by the way, the script for us was done up by Caitlin Palmer and the grads as well, some of the grads, but Caitlin did a fantastic job. So, two thousand two brought with it the invasion of Afghanistan. We left it to our fearless leaders in the States to sort that one out. But perhaps we should have just brought in Scooby-Doo. Well, that's what the grass is, baby. Just north of Kamloops, B.C., in a peaceful but lively community called Barriere, can be found. Usually this place is peaceful, a peaceful dwelling, but there's a spot in this town that a dark cloud has been cast upon. Barriere Secondary School. An ominous presence has loomed the halls since 1999. The washing machines run when no one is there, and piles of homework get mysteriously missing. Students have been scared for years. That is, until Scooby and his gang arrived.
Yeah, Scooby Snacks. Come on, gang, we have a mystery to solve. Legend has it the Mitchell should be here any minute.
Guys, what's that?
Let's leave.
Oh, hey, sir.
How's it going?
Run for what?
Hey, guys, I got some masks on.
Damn dog. Yeah. show. Oh my gosh, these kids have it so organized. We're on to 2003. Sadly brought us, as everybody knows, the barrier fire. These grads were only 3 years old at the time, and most of these grads were living in the valley. I'm sure you parents can remember screaming toddlers on the blazing hot summer days trying to find solace in Riverside Park or wherever your family fled. It's hard to imagine that the music and movies of that year would still be so relevant to those kids today.
Hey, it's kind of quiet in here. Would you like some music?
Oh, no, I'm fine, really. That's...
Well, you know what? It's fine. I'll go play some music.
Just a second, we'll get everybody. Yeah, could you all please tune in? Thank you, Dolan. obviously, the lives of our grads would be forever changed by social media. The lives of everyone would be changed by social media. In Barriere, you have probably seen a few awesome things posted and some things that, well, maybe should have been left at the ranch. When you think of the song Redneck Woman, can you make any connections in the Barriere area and happenings Facebook page? What do you think about that? Here comes the kids with the redneck. Well, this brings us down to 2005. YouTube was founded. Do you know what YouTube is, Christine? I do, but it confuses me. Oh. I use Crest. And the same-sex marriage became legal. Times were clearly changing for kids everywhere. But some things in Barriere will always remain the same. Most importantly, Johnny Cash.
Thank you.
Okay, so a man is recovering from surgery when a nurse asks him how he's feeling. I'm okay, but I didn't like the four-letter word the doctor used in surgery. What? What did he say? Oops. Oh, these kids are amazing kids. I don't know if everybody knows them all, but they will get to know them tonight, and they obviously have a lot of talent. Oh, yeah, they do. Tonight's show is actually they're raising funds to go on a dry grab. The community has done some amazing fundraising down the liquor store. Thank you all for drinking. Yeah, we do tend to raise a lot of money at the liquor store. As well, don't forget the silent auction table. If you outbid me, you're on my good list. Thanks. In 2008, our beloved elementary school, The Ridge, closed shortly after the release of the very first iPhone. And there's been about 20 different iPhones since then, right? I know. Now tell me if you can see the connection between pasty white teenagers who stay up all night displaying unexpected angry outbursts in the introduction of iPhones. Sounds like a tale fit for Twilight and Vampire Lovers. Here's a rendition of Twilight.
Thank you.
how much do you charge? The lawyer responds, I charge $1,000 to answer three questions. Bloody hell, that's a bit expensive, isn't it? Yes, what's your third question? World events in 2010. 2010 was a year of development here close to home. We had the 2010 Winter Olympics coming to Vancouver in a few short months. Large development in the Whistler, Blackcomb area, and Lower Mainland was being prepared to bring the game home to Canada for the first time in 22 years. This was a huge part of 2009 in Canada. Also, as well, was a soccer star named Cristiano Ronaldo is awarded the 2008 FIFA World Player of the Year at a ceremony in Zurich. After following his teenage dream, just like art grads are following their dreams, we have Shaq and Shani with Katy Perry's hit, Teenage Dream.
Oh,
which George was born. Rob Ford admitted to smoking crack, while lead star Corey Monteith died of the same affliction. All the while, we were supported by our friends in Alberta as they battled some worst floods in history. 2013 was quite a year. Thank God for Disney. 2013 also brought us Disney's musical hit, Frozen. Oh my Lord, we used to sing it here all the time. And it brought us some valuable lessons along with it. Let it go. Let it go. Our grads have certainly demonstrated this ability when it comes to handing in their essays on time. Here are the grads with Frozen.
I'm
Wow, that was awesome. Man, by 2015, we were on to the iPhone 6. And drones began to deliver our Amazon packages. And our kids were working on their epic dance move. Just watch John, Wyatt, Tyler, Sheldon, and Daryl. Watch them whip. Watch them nay-nay. Watch me.
Thank you.
PSS grads that have attended tonight?
Past PSS grads.
Okay. We're going to start with the 1960s.
This is good. So thank you everybody for coming. Let's hear a huge round of applause for our students and all of their experts here on stage. Share the books at school so that we can get them in the yearbook. I think there should be a couple pages dedicated to the Grad Fashion Show. So thank you everybody for coming out. Thank you for your generosity and participating in the grad fundraisers. And thank you to everybody who put so much work into this event. Thank you.
Sparkles on my dress. By the way, did anybody know this? I have the worst dress ever, I'm okay. Welcome back. We hope your bellies are full and your wallets are empty from the silent auction. This year, we thought that we'd treat our audience to a blast from the past with our retro brass, ranging from last year back to 1971. We found friends, relatives, and staff who have been voluntold to come on up and walk the catwalk once again. Here's our crowd. John Prue, escorting past left grad, the Melissa Clyde, from 2016. Vanessa Clyde. Vanessa's most memorable moment is going to the officials for basketball in 2016. Currently, Vanessa is enrolled in the Natural Resource Science Program at TLU. John's pet peeve is people who are awesome around.
Is escorted by
escorting his mother, Jennifer, who graduated in 2005. Jennifer's pet peeves back in 2005 were stupid questions, loud people, annoying laughs, and people I shouldn't name. Daryl Jewel's most memorable moment is working out on HP with Thug Life. Getting locked in the change room for 3 hours until someone finds
Thank you for having me.
Thank you.
grandmother, Shirley Whitman.
Show, putting it on. She put the script together, as I said.
Director of Studies this year at TLU. She plans on getting her red seal as a heavy-duty commercial transport technician. Wow. Dakota, he's quiet and shy, but can be really humorous when he wants to be. And I'm sorry, I didn't get his planned future. I believe it's the arts. Going into the arts, and then that totally suits him. Shakua is one of our great athletes and plays numerous sports. Always hyper, happy, and humorous. Remember him and Paul Kamenowski. Doing a comedian routine together. That was hilarious. Actually, Shaq and Dakota were both with Paul a lot doing comedian routines, and oh my gosh, were they funny. Lucky those five girls, they get to escort all of those boys. We've got Shannon Metcalf, Wyatt McLaren, and Dawson Weaver. Shannon joined us this year from Vancouver area. She's such a friendly young lady. She became fast friends with our grads. We love seeing her join the show, and I know there was something mentioned about her planned future earlier. Wyatt, who's always late. But you know what? He's such a charmer. He comes in with the best reasons and gets his mom to call, of course. He's on his way to traveling the world and possibly running a restaurant. Dawson, we're so proud of him, and he's doing, he loves welding, he's a shop guy. He's always, I know he runs his dad's equipment at home, he's out in the logging field all the time. He's always happy and he's smiling, and I think he's great. Here we go. He's a little shy and is doing phenomenal. He's been at your camp all
And Peyton also took some photos for us, so let's give them a hand. Lights and sound, we had the CAT team, which is Cam Kersley, Aaron Mansell, and Tyson Schilling. And for our props, we had Caleb and Chan. Great job over there. And a big round of applause for all of our retro grads. It was a neat addition to the basketball. And a big thank you to all of our sponsors who made this event possible. There's so many to mention. We're just going to mention a few of the really big ones. Thank you in our community to Sun Peaks, up and down, and up and down the valley. We appreciate all of your support. Also our parents, moms, and all of our Cougar moms. Without your blood, sweat, and tears, this event would not have been possible. And a very big thank you to Ms. Dola. Yeah. For those of you who do not know who Ms. Dola is, she is most of our English 12 teacher, and she has constructed this entire fashion show that would not have been possible without her. Can we please have Ms. Dola come up to the front? Also, can we have our MCs come up? We would like to give them a huge thank you as well. The person Kathy for MCing our festival. And that concludes